For example, in case if a dual processor server is used in the network which contains separate memory storage for each processor with same address range, then to access a memory address in a specific processor, the unused bytes within the memory address parameter can be used by defining it as memory identifiers. In the last video, we had a look into details of read data by identifier 22 service. Let's have a look into the next diagnostic service, that's read memory by address 23 service. Before we dive in, let's first understand the purpose of this service. Read memory by address service allows the client to request data stored in server memory by providing start address and size of the memory. The data provided may include analog input and output signal values, digital input and output signal values, internal data, and system status, etc. The format and definition of the data record shall be vehicle manufacturer specific. With this understanding, let's dive into the request definition of the service. Firstly, we have read memory by address request SID, which maps to value 23, followed by address and length format identifier, which can take value from 0 to FF. The address and length format identifier parameter defines the number of bytes used for the memory address and memory size parameter. Each nibble of the byte is encoded separately, with bit 7 to 4 defining the length of the memory size parameter and bit 3 to 0 defining the memory address parameter. It's also allowed to use fixed address length format identifier value, wherein unused bytes within the memory address or memory size parameter shall be padded with value 0. Let's look into our next set of parameters, memory address and memory size. As the name implies, memory address parameter is the starting address of the server memory from which the data is to be retrieved. Byte M of the parameter is always the least significant byte of the address being referred in the server. And if required, most significant bytes of the address can be used as memory identifier. For example, in case if a dual processor server is used in the network which contains separate memory storage for each processor with same address range, then to access a memory address in a specific processor, the unused bytes within the memory address parameter can be used by defining it as memory identifiers. Usage of the unused memory address parameter shall be defined by vehicle manufacturer or system suppliers. Coming to memory size, this parameter specifies the number of bytes to be read starting from address specified by memory address parameter. Let's now look into the positive response. Positive response contains read memory by address response SID, that's 63, followed by data record requested by read memory by address request. Data formatting of the data provided as response shall be defined by vehicle manufacturer or system supplier. Following are the NRCs supported. NRC 13, which is incorrect message length or invalid format. This NRC shall be sent if the length of the requested message is wrong. NRC 22, conditions not correct. This NRC shall be sent if the operating conditions of the server are not met to perform the required actions. NRC 31, request out of range. This NRC shall be sent if one of the following is true. If any memory address within the requested memory space is invalid, or if any address within the memory space requested is restricted, or if the memory size parameter value in the request message is not supported by the server, or if the memory size parameter value in the request message is zero, or if the specified address and length format identifier is not valid. NRC 33, security access denied. This NRC shall be sent if any memory address with the memory space requested is secure and server is not in unlock state. Diagram shows the order of evaluation of different NRCs. Firstly, we have the NRC 13 check for minimum length of the request, followed by address and length format identifier applicability check, which if fails, would lead to NRC 31. Next, there is a check on the total length of the request, which in case if it fails, results in NRC 13 again, followed by a check on the validity of memory address and memory size and the request support in the current session, which if fails, leads to NRC 31. Next, there is a check on the security to confirm if the secure access is required for the service or if the ECU has the right access. In case if this check fails, would lead to NRC 33. And lastly, we have a check on the fulfillment of preconditions before executing the service, which if fails, leads to NRC 22. If all the above checks are through, then positive response for the service shall be provided. Let's look into our first example now. Consider a server with 32-bit addressing. Then to access data from memory address 11001489 of 260 bytes, the client request shall be as follows. In the request, the address and the length format identifier shall be set to 24, 2 for memory size length and 4 for memory address length. Server shall respond with data as follows. Next, let's look into our second example, where a server has 16-bit addressing. Then to access the data from the memory address 2489 of 5 bytes, the client request shall be as follows. The address and length format identifier in the request shall be set to 12, 1 for memory size length and 2 for memory address length. Server shall respond with data as follows. With this, we had a detailed look into read address by memory 23 service. In upcoming session, we'll have a detailed look into read data by periodic identifier 2A service. Thank you.